Hey and welcome to Everything Electrical Engineering. Today we'll be discussing line compensation. Reactors and capacitors are installed for medium to long overhead transmission lines to maintain voltage regulation, increase current carrying capacity, and provide line stability. They can also be used as filters on certain protection systems. There are four possible line configurations, which will be discussed here. Also, don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss future content. Considering power being transported from generation to load center from medium to long transmission lines, if the line is lightly loaded or no load is applied, the voltage at the receiving end will be larger than the sending end. This is known as the Ferranti effect. Conversely, for heavily loaded lines, the voltage at the receiving end will decrease due to the power factor of the loads applied. Now that we understand why we need line compensation, let's discuss the configuration methods. First, let's discuss inductors, also known as reactors. To observe the Ferranti effect, I used MATLAB to simulate an open circuit long transmission line and then plotted the voltage. I added a reactor to maintain the receiving end and compared this with the uncompensated line. From the results, one can see the voltage on the receiving end for an uncompensated line is significantly larger than the sending end. The voltage rise at the receiving end is known as the Ferranti effect, and is caused by charge and current interacting with the inductance of the line. The charge and current is equal to 2 pi times F, the frequency, times C, the capacitance, and V, the voltage. Thus, the Ferranti effect will be more onerous at higher voltages and frequencies. The capacitance of the line is due to its composition. We have conductors separated by a dielectric medium, air in this case. Another electrical component that has the same composition is a capacitor. Shunt inductors are usually installed at the receiving end or at points along the line from phase to neutral for all phases. Reactors by definition can absorb unwanted reactive power, reduce overvoltages, and maintain the voltage at the receiving end. For transient events such as lightning and switching, reactors will reduce any overvoltages. However, as the line gets more heavily loaded, the reactors will reduce the line loadability if not removed. The transmission line constants in the MATLAB graph were outlined in a previous video, where I compared the exact and approximate line model and showed that there is only a small difference between the two. See the description for the video link. Series reactor compensation is not readily used in power systems, at least not for line compensation. It is generally used to limit high currents for certain earthen systems or filters for high frequency signals. As mentioned already, for heavily loaded lines, the voltage will be lower at the receiving end. This is because more inductive loads turn on throughout the day, which consume reactive power. A lag in power factor is created. This subsequently reduces the voltage at the receiving end. I covered a video in detail on power factor, please see the description where I go into more detail. Shunt capacitors provide reactive power to offset the reactive power absorbed by the loads and maintain a preset voltage at the receiving end terminals. Capacitors are usually connected directly to the bus or to the tertiary windings of a transformer and installed along the route to minimize the voltage drop and losses. A hybrid of the two shunt compensators is static var compensation, which includes thyristor switched reactors in parallel with capacitors. Static var compensators can be automated to deliver reactive power when the line is heavily loaded and absorb reactive power for periods when the line might be lightly loaded, therefore increasing the line loadability and reducing voltage fluctuations. Renewable generators commonly use static var compensators to be distribution or transmission code compliant. Series capacitor compensation is connected with capacitor banks installed in series with each phase conductor at selected points along the line. Installing capacitors in series will reduce the line inductance, surge impedance, and propagation constants, which are inversely proportional to the line loadability. In a previous video, I covered surge impedance loading, where one could see that a lower value of surge impedance results in higher transmission line loadability. Series capacitor compensation will improve the line stability limits, voltage regulation, and maximize the line loadability for a fraction of the cost of a new transmission line. However, there are some drawbacks to this configuration, such as having the full current going through the capacitor will cause harmful overvoltages during certain fault conditions. Special protection switchgear to automatically detect and bypass high currents during fault conditions is required. There are other issues with harmonics and low frequency oscillations, which need to be taken into consideration, as this may negatively affect turbine generators' mechanical systems. Thanks for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss future videos.